one more step in a path that this administration has clearly been following. It's a path that I boil down to basically two goals. One is to make as difficult as possible for people who are foreign nationals and who are coming especially, you know, from countries that our president has really bad words to describe, not talking about, to come in. And he is committed to do anything he can to make it as hard as possible for people to come in. And the second goal that this administration is pursuing is to make sure that he does whatever he needs to inject as many people as he can, who again look in a certain way, you know, look like you and I, if you want, and get us out of the country. He is so committed to that that he's even willing to look into how you and I became U.S. naturalized citizens. And if they find something that is, in their view, out of order, get us out. So that's what this administration is about. When it comes to foreign nationals, given that the majority of foreign nationals in the country are indeed Mexicans, Latin American, Caribbean immigrants nowadays. And the last thing I would say is this attempt to restrict the right to asylum will be challenged. You know, we know that there are quite a few allies already prepared to actually go to court on this particular attempt to indeed curtail the right of people who wish to seek asylum in the U.S. And they have the right to do so, not only based on domestic law, but international law.
And I think that, to me, that is something that we need to focus on. We need to, you know, when Donald Trump talks about the caravan, you know, he creates all the, stokes all this fear and negativity. I mean, what we need to do is actually help introduce people to who is in this caravan. You know, who are the people who are fleeing the violence in Central America? You know, what are they going through? You see these mothers with these little babies. You see people who are fleeing gang violence and all kinds of other violence in these countries. I mean, I really believe in the goodness of the Americans. They respond in a way that's positive. And so we need to be aggressive in getting out the real story, telling people what the, what really is happening in Central America. You know, when Oscar and I were in Honduras and El Salvador in August, I mean, we heard firsthand from person after person after person after person about the incredible violence, the threats. You know, and El Salvador is more dangerous than Afghanistan today.